So first, I will thanks about accepting me to present my works. My works about positive solutions for critical elliptic system within human condition. I'm a teacher in mathematics in higher school of management at Tlemcen in Algiers. So we start by introduction. Second, historical brief. Finally, existence of positive solution. So we consider the following, the existence of positive solution for the following system where the weights P, Q are continuous, positive and continuous, and A, B, C, eta are real parameters, and alpha, beta, theta, phi, alpha plus beta equal 2 star, and 2 star is the critical Sobolev exponent for embedding H01 into L2 star of the age of omega, and the 2 star is the critical Sobolev exponent for embedding H01 into L2 star of omega. This injection or this embedding are continuous but not compact. So the major difficulty of this kind of problem is that the critical exponent of Sobolev, in the sense that it is a Hinkel value on which the injection is no longer compact, then the question of existence of positive solution is delicate. So in 1991, Adimurti, Mancini, Wang has treated this kind of problem where the weight P is a constant, Q equals zero. They have proved the existence of positive solutions for lambda big and enough, and some condition on the edge of omega that satisfy the geometrical condition at a certain point in the edge of omega, and the mean curvature at this point is positive. Next, ESED in 2007 have treated the same problem, but when the weight P is not a constant. So under some condition on P and Q and lambda Kp, the seconds of eigenvalue for the operator within human boundary condition, and if one of the following condition is satisfied, then the problem admits a solution. So the aim of this work is to generalize the ESED problem to a system and to extend the subcritical case to the critical case. So we define the edge of omega is said to be satisfying the geometrical condition at x0. If there exists a neighborhood U of x0, such that this intersection lies on one of the sides of the tangent plane at x0. So we can rewrite the above system in the vectorial form, where A is a matrix characterized by the parameter ABC. This matrix admits two eigenvalues, mu1 and mu2, and H1 of U and H2 of U is equal to this equality. In our work, we consider these possibilities. So we put a condition on ABC, then the eigenvalue of the matrix are negatives. So we work in a space H with this norm. And we define the best Sobolev constants S and S1. So we know that these constants are achieved by a family of functions U of X and W of X. And S alpha beta, there is a relation between S alpha beta and the best Sobolev constant is this equality. So the theorem for the existence of positive solution, let omega be a bounded domain so that the edge of omega satisfy the geometrical condition at y and the mean curvature at this point is positive. We assume that the eigenvalue of the matrix are negatives. P and Q satisfy 1, 2, 3 respectively. Then our system has a positive solution. So we define the energy functional G eta corresponding to our problem by this. And it's clearly that the functional G eta is continuous of class C1. And the solution of the system corresponds to a critical point of G eta. a powerful tool for proving the existence of a critical point of a functional is given by the following lemma. So the lemma is called the lemma of Kohl of Ambrose Tirabinovich. Let G eta, continuous of class C1, that satisfied the Pallismel condition. We suppose that there exists a neighborhood V of 0 in H and the positive constants rho and L, such that I and 2I is the geometrical condition are verified. Then G eta has a critical value C, such that C superior to A. That is to say, if we put C equal infinimum of maximum of G eta, with gamma is the path which connects 0 to 1, then C is a critical value of G eta and the C is superior to A. So as the problem under consideration is a critical, then the Sobolev embedding are not a compact. So to overcome this loss of compactness, we have determined a good level of Pallismel condition C star, so that the functional G eta satisfies the Pallismel condition for C inferior at C star. For each fixed eta positive, G eta satisfies the Pallismel condition with C inferior at C star equal minimum of C and D. So we have a second U and V n is relatively compact. For a proof, let U and Vn be a sequence of Pallismel. So let's verify G eta at this sequence converge vers C and Frege derivatives at this sequence converge vers zero. So we can conclude that this norm at U and Vn is bounded. So we can extract a subsequence U and Vn such that converge weakly in H. In view of concentration compactness principle by Lyons, we conclude the result. To achieve the desired result, we show that the energy functional is less than the Pallismel level. So under the assumption of theorem 1, there exists U tilde V tilde such that sup of G eta inferior strictly at C star. So for proof, we verify this lemma in two cases. The first case, when C star equals C, we use extremal function, and by some estimation, we arrive at a result. So for the second case, where C star equals D, by the same method as before, we got the result. So according to the lemma 1 and 2, G eta satisfies all the assumptions of lemma of the Kohl. There exists C, which is a critical value for G eta, and UV is a solution for our system. By the strong maximum principle, we get the positivity of U and V. This is some reference. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Professor Yamina, for your good presentation.
Thank you.
Let me ask for questions. Is there any questions or comments to Professor?